So, what is a VLAN? VLAN stands for a virtual local area network. Now, the part that makes this LAN virtual is that we're segmenting the network not by the configuration in the connected Ethernet devices, but rather in the software configuration of the switch or router. This software configuration uses a physical port on the switch to define the VLAN of that device. So we can segment, let's say, the first four ports for VLAN 2 and the next four for VLAN 3. Now, why would segmenting out a network like this be important? There are two main reasons: controlling network traffic and security. When it comes to network traffic, the big help from VLAN segmentation comes from limiting broadcast communication. See, when a device sends out a broadcast communication, every device in its physical LAN receives that communication. The burden is then upon the end device to determine if the communication is meant for them or not. If this communication is used a lot, it can easily be seen how much this will reduce your network bandwidth. Now, if we limit the LAN scope of these devices by separating them into these virtual LANs, we can maximize the network and reduce the overall workload on all of the devices. By reducing the pathways into the device and who can talk with them, we also make the device more secure. In this graphic, we have the Productivity 2000 PLC. And it has two Ethernet ports, one for remote I.O. and one for all other Ethernet communication. This PLC needs to be connected to a Seymour HMI and a GS remote VFD drive. Now, the PLC needs to talk to the remote I.O. drive, and the HMI needs to talk to the PLC. But the HMI and the remote drive do not need to talk to one another. With VLAN, segregating this network is simple. The remote I.O. port of the Productivity 2000 and the remote I.O. drive are plugged into ports that are set up for VLAN 3 on ports 5 through 8. And then the HMI and the other Ethernet port of the Productivity is plugged into ports set up for VLAN 2 on ports 1 through 4. Okay, let's see how this would configure in the Stride managed switch. First, we would need to get access to the managed switch. This can be done by typing the IP address of the switch into our web browser, and then you'll be asked to enter your username and password for the switch. On the left-hand side, you will see the VLAN option. Expand it. Now select the VLAN configuration. Here we're going to create our first VLAN. First, we're going to name the VLAN group 2, PLC and HMI, and give it a group number of 2. We are then going to select ports 1 through 4, and make them untagged. After you're done, select Add. Now you'll see your VLAN down in the group below. Now to create group 3. We will call this group PLC and Remote I.O. with the VLAN ID of 3. We will then select ports 5 through 8 and place them as untagged. Click on Add. Now you will see VLAN group 3 down here. Okay, by pressing Apply, you will load this configuration. Now, here's a problem. If you stop here and the switch is rebooted, this configuration will be lost. To make this configuration the primary configuration in the switch, we must select Save the Configuration. Couple points to wrap up with. It is important to leave some ports on default for switch configuration. Also, the entire configuration resides in the managed switch. So to ensure that you get your equipment up quickly in case of switch failure, it is important to keep backups of this configuration. Here is a link to a video covering uploading and downloading the configuration. If you need any help with using an Automation Direct device, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support team during regular business hours. They will be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There's lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post questions directed at Automation Direct's technical support staff there. They do not monitor the forums on a regular basis.